Look at that amount of gold in here. Gold, 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 gold. Everything is gold. And because it's gold, it sounds better. Well, that's what they say. So, I do have all the EQs finished, ready. All the preamps are done. All the summing is done. So, what's the next step? We've got a few more things to do. We need to add the faders, which I, by the way, have. I do have 50 Alps K faders. And I know that you are asking, where did you get them from? Well, I just bought them. Actually, secondhand, because they aren't being made anymore. But these are in great condition. They are from a console that was almost never used. So I've got 55 of these. They were really expensive. But I first need to design the front plates and a PCB which will do the soloing stuff as well. So with some relays on it. So I'm not going to continue with that. I'm actually going to continue with the other type of module that's in there that didn't have my service yet. The routing. This is the actual routing module. And it's got a few buttons on here. First of all, we got the group selector over here. We've got the aux selector. We've got the aux volume. We've got the fold back volume, which is very special, but I will get to that in a bit. And we have the panorama button, which is actually upside down, as you can see. So this is center, this is left, and this is right. While a normal panorama button would be like, this is left, this is right, and this is center. This one has been heavily modified. The former owner of the console used it in a different way than I'm going to use it. And the first thing that is modified is the group selector. The console has got 8 different subgroups. Subgroup 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on this side, 6, 7, 8, 0 for nothing, and left and right. And these are all stereo subgroups, so we actually have 16 monos. And the former owner only wanted to use mono subgroups, and that was because he had a 16 channel tape machine attached to it. If he wanted to route something to the first channel of the tape machine, he simply said, I want to route to subgroup 1 and I want to route to the left side. That's where this switch is for. We can choose between the left side, nothing, and the right side. We can also do that with subgroup 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. If we route to a subgroup, we cannot use our master left, right panorama button. This switch over here is right now to route it to the master bus. So he could route like, you know, to channel 1 of the tape machine like this, and also route to the master bus simultaneously for pre-listening. And this would be handy for recording, but this was like 30 years ago or something. So I don't want that anymore. And this is clearly a modification that has been added to the console afterwards. I want to remove this. So this switch will be disconnected, but I will keep it in here so I can give it a function in the future. I don't know which one yet. I was first planning on having this a mute solo switch, but that switch will be on top of my fader, on top of my fader front plate. Because that's an easier location to switch, you know, because your hands are already there. But also because it's technically seen a better location because everything is already there that I need to have there. So this will be a non-used switch anymore, but I keep it in there just for the future when I figure out something I want to use it for. About the routing to master bus switch, I don't know yet what I'm going to do with it. I think that I will keep the function on it so I can do parallel stuff. So I can route it to the master bus and to a subgroup simultaneously for parallel compression or stuff. So the aux routing button is also an interesting one because we have auxes 1 to 4, but we have them on both sides and it's actually pretty simple. This side is pre-fader auxes and this side is post-fader auxes. So if you want to route post or pre-fader, you actually have to route it to a, well, different aux bus. So this is the aux volume. I'm keeping these two as it is. I'm actually keeping the rest as it is. The fold back is an interesting one. That will become an extra aux channel on my console, so I will have 5 auxes outputs for effects or what else. Back in the days, this was the channel that was used to playback in the room, and this is a 60s console. So in the 60s they weren't using headphones, they were using an actual speaker in the room which played back the sound which the musicians had to follow for their recordings. So this will become an extra aux channel. So I have 4 auxes of which I can only select one over here and one which I can always use on all channels, and then the panorama. So if we look inside of this module, it's a big mess, so prepare. And the interesting thing, and that's also why I know that this thing has been heavily modified, is that you can actually see here that the switch for the routing actually already has 2 separated rotary switches in here. One for the left channel and one for the right channel. And this switch is actually only connecting one of the two to the bus. So this has been added later. You can also see it because they've used different type of wires. My mission now is to restore this one back to original, and this sounds more difficult than it actually is, because it simply involves disconnecting this switch and you know, routing the wires back to the original positions on the rotary switch. So it isn't actually that difficult, but yeah. Also, there are some electrolytic capacitors in here, radial ones, and I simply also need to replace those, because only God knows how old these things are and how long they will take before they start degrading. So that's a bit not something that I really want to do, because it's a very difficult soldering job, because as you can see there isn't any PCB in here. Yeah, it's just what I gotta do. Also, maybe interesting to see, to watch the panorama, as you can see, is actually 2 potentiometers that are, you know, connected the different way around each other. And it's actually a volume control per channel. So the left channel has got a volume control and the right one. And if I rotate it, one will get louder and the other one will get less loud, quieter. Yeah. All right, so that's it for this video, and this will also be the next part of the console revision, which will again take me way longer than I actually want it to take, but I guess I just have to accept that by now. Yeah, with that being said, thanks a lot for watching this. If you liked it, let me know. I'm always trying to make more of these videos, but I simply forget to record everything because I'm such in a... it's not a rush, but I'm really, like, you know, working on it, and then I forget to film it. So I will try to film it more if you guys like it. All right. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.